My name is Lawal Ola Taufik, physical and health education teacher. I am here to talk about a topic, development development of operational manual. Operational plan and teaching plan for a modern school. First of all, operational manual. It is part of the strategic plan of a school. It helps you to contribute in specific details on how to achieve what the school plan to achieve. Before we talk about operational plan, there is strategic plan comes in. Strategic plan is the general plan the school has. For example, this year we have what so and so for the year. Second year we have so and so for the second year. It is a long-term plan for like 2 to 5 years. A school plan, strategic plan for programs they have for like 5 years. But in the strategic plan, we have the operational plan. The operational plan comes in different kind. It comes from the different departments, different units, different sectors under the same school. For example, when you are planning operational plan, there are so many things you put into consideration, especially you as the head of department. The program you have for the term, let me use the last intersport we did as an example. It has been in the strategic plan of the school that intersport will be organized this year. Then we now plan for the intersport by the science department. Under the science department, we organized a kind of a different kind of committees to sit and plan on when we are supposed to have the intersport. Then we came up with it that the best time for us to have the intersport should be the second term. That is an example of operational plan. It is limited today to day-to-day, day-to-a-day basic activity. A day activity in a particular year, that is operational. What you have this time, for example, again, like we have Science Week, it is for the whole of that week, for that particular year. That is an example of operational manual. So the difference between operational manual and the strategic manual now is that the strategic plan is a long-term plan organized by the school. Planned by the head of school. While operational plan is done by departmental. by the head of the department. Now, there are some things that are very, very important in planning operational, in developing operational plan. One of them is time. Time. When are we supposed to have it? Just as I gave an example of the last Inter Sport we did. When are we supposed to have the Inter Sport? When are we supposed to have the Science Week? When are we supposed to have a kind of other program like take exhibition of science products produced by the students in the school and other things like that? We talk about time, then we focus on the plan, the reason for this. What is the reason for us to plan these things that we want to organize? In strategic plan, you focus on a longer time or different time for different years, while the operational plan deal with that particular year. And it means that the whole goal are more specific to the department rather than strategic plan, for the general institution. But for the operational plan, it is basically for the department. Then, then the third one is the budget. The budget for strategic plan is being handled by the head of the school, either the principal or the head teacher in the primary section. But for the operational plan, everything will be that has to do with budgeting will be given to the head of department to run. Then another thing, there is what we call SMART. Let me write it this way. SMART. There is what we call SMART in developing the operational plan. The first one is specific. In developing the operational plan, you have to be specific what and what are needed. What and what do we need? You have to decide on what we want to plan on. First of all, it has to be problem solving. Is it problem solving? It is simply being clear and specific. You may also see operational plan as a program that is more specific than general strategic plan. Then, the second one, the end there, is talking about measurable. This is where you will identify how long it will take to obtain your goal and the objective. It also means that you have to identify when a goal or objective is already a successful one. For example, this school had a plan of organizing Inter Sport, but by the time it is done departmentally, you can take the measurement and know if your goal has been achieved. It's been achieved, rather than waiting for the next 5 years in strategic plan and say, we did Inter Sport last year. We are comparing it with it. So this one, immediately after the program has been done, or what you have in your operational plan has been done, you can measure it, you can, so that you know whether the goal or the objective is being achieved. Then the third A here, under the SMART, the A here is attainable. This is the part of SMART where you identify if the goal or the objective your department is trying to achieve can be possible for the time being given to you or the fund that is present in your department. The money given to you, if it is going to be enough, it is under this attainable that you know. If it is time given to you, if it's going to be, for example, when we are planning for the inter-house sport, we need to prepare the student in one way or the other. We made the timetable, we requested for time, and fortunately it was approved by the head of school. But it was the department, within the department, that we sat and, within the committee setup, that we sat and we discovered that this is the time that should be given to us to organize the intersport and getting the student ready. That's the attainable. Then the next one there is R, the relevant. The department which is assigned to a task according to the strategic plan should be able to think and decide if the plan is relevant to their work. Now, let me still use the intersport as the same as an example. If sport is not important or is not relevant, it will not be added to educational curriculum of the student. Students need that. That was why it was included in their curriculum, that intersport should be organized for them. So you think of whether the program you have in your plan, in your operational plan, is relevant or not. Then the last thing here is timely. After you and your team have decided on what to do, it is now time for you to decide on the deadline of each of the tasks, the objective already being plotted out. You may also see recruitment plan templates. What I'm trying to say in essence there is, you have to give yourself, apart from the time given to you, apart from the budgeting, everything given to you, the time, from so-so-so time to so-so-so time, we prepare for the program. Now, we are supposed to have the program by 10 a.m. 10 a.m. will not be enough. It will not be nice because we want parents to be there and they have to go to their office, maybe probably get to their office before coming back. You have to plan all these things in your operational plan, may be mentioned in the strategic plan. Then we have another five steps in developing a operational plan. The first one is know your school current situation. Like, for example, the current situation of my school, we have just the football field. And when we were planning the intersport, we did not include some other games, like that has to do with indoor games, because we are yet to have some of the equipment. So the current situation of the school is we have only the field, and the field was used for athletics and football alone. So you know your school current situation. Then the second one is specify the desired outcome. What do you stand to achieve You have to be specific about it. That's the second step. Then the third step is design and implement an improvement strategy. One of the things we implement as a strategy was the committee, various type of committee we formed. It is not an issue of only a game master and the house master alone. We involve almost all the teachers in the school in various committee, and it helps us to work well. The fourth step there, we have measured and monitored the result. Now, after the inter-house sport, we were able to get the results in some of the events. We were able to pick some of our players, the players that can represent the school in various games like in football and even in athletics. In case we have outing, we now know those students who are capable of representing the school. This is where you measure and monitor the result. And those students, their names have been compiled and we started having separate training with them. This is one of the way to monitor the results of your operational plan, or the result of the achievement. Reflect on what you have learned. You reflect on what you have learned. What we have learned from this one, we reflect it by the time we are planning another one. But while in developing teaching plan, in a model school like this, it is not possible as a teacher to go into the classroom and teach without a well-planned teaching, teaching method. There are so many things you have to put together before you go into the class to teach. One of them is the lesson notes, your lesson plan, availability of teaching aids, because teaching aid is an important aspect of teaching. So when you are planning your teaching, you have to include your teaching aids, because it will help the children to understand you better. You think about classroom management is another thing to put into consideration when planning your teaching. Also, student involvement. Do you just go to class and tell students stories? Do you ask them questions? Do you allow them to contribute? Do you know that to allow them to contribute to in their own capacity is the best? You don't just go to class and be teaching, telling students the stories. Let them think, ask them questions. It will also help you as a teacher to know their level of understanding. Then, whatever you are teaching, whatever you are planning, whenever you are planning your teaching, you should make sure it is a child-centered in a model school like Nigeria Korea Model School, these are essential to serve as an exemplary school to others. You plan your lesson before you go to the class. Thank you very much.